Ukraine and the struggle and the challenges faced by the Ukrainians and Russia's illegal occupation of Crimea and its nefarious activities, deadly activities in the east of the country, has been one of the main foreign policy focuses of the Heritage Foundation over the past 3 years or so. And for us, what's happening in Ukraine symbolizes a larger struggle facing Europe today. This idea of self-determination, national sovereignty, being able to choose your own destiny, choose how and by whom you're governed. And this is very important because Russia threatens to undermine these basic assumptions that many of us have taken for granted here in the US and in Europe.
Є велика амплітуда, різна така амплітуда висловлювань і поглядів серед України, які оцінюють ситуацію в Україні як зрада, а президентська лінія говорить, що в Україні все добре.
And there are political factions in Ukraine that recognize certain actions as treasonous, while the current government accepts them calmly. We Ukrainians often commit one serious mistake in our efforts to convince our European and Western partners.
Ми просимо допомогу, ми б'ємо на жалість та на історичну справедливість.
We often justify our request for assistance based on historical injustices and seeking justice.
У жорсткому світі 21-го століття ці дві речі вже не працюють.
In the 21st century, these two arguments are no longer effective.
Працює питання тільки інтересу і вигоди.
Today, what is priority considerations are national interests, національні інтереси і що?
І вигоди.
And advantages.
Підтримати Україну є вигідно Сполученим Штатам.
It is advantageous for the United States to support Ukraine.
We're all on the same team together. We have a message, and I think that message, obviously, in terms of our presenters this morning, was quite obvious. That it is advantageous for the United States to support Ukraine. We've been saying this for the past 3 years. We can't say it enough. Let's not get into this, what is called Ukraine fatigue syndrome. There's a lot of work yet left to do in Ukraine. And I think today's entire day of advocacy on Capitol Hill, as well as our event this evening, is significant in terms of our message. So thank you to everyone.
Not also the for myself on behalf of the president, but in this official document is also included recognition of your contribution of efforts for memorial, recognize Holodomor, here in the United States, and other things. So it's a great pleasure and honor to have stand behind that.
I see it as a gift that defines us and nurtures us and sustains us. And like any gift, it has its greatest value when it's exchanged. And who exchanges it more powerfully and boldly than the Ukrainian-American community?
Ukrainian National Information Service, 40 years. I was thinking that's 1977. Is my math right? And I was thinking I've been gifted with some extra years. And I was first in Ukraine in 1973. Maybe some of you were too. And thinking back to what it was like as an occupied Soviet territory, state, and how hard it is to birth a child and how hard it is to birth a nation. And through my lifetime, I have seen Ukraine come into the possibility of liberty. The largest land mass of any nation in Europe, and the potential that is there on a very large stage.
It's an honor.